Challenging orthodoxy means challenging your routine thinking, the job you do routinely. Say, for example, if I am running an educational institution, what are the orthodoxies there? That we always, you know, don't even question. First is that, okay, there is demand for some courses and students will come to the institute to study. Then if they come to study, that means I have to have a classroom. I have to have some chairs and tables. I have to have some gadget, electronic equipment, whether it is LCD projector, a computer. Then I have to define course curriculum to them beforehand. I have to give them the schedule beforehand. Then there has to be some evaluation assessment. In a year, that may be, you know, end with an year-end exam, and there has to be evaluation, some grading has to be given after that. So these are the routine things we feel that has to be there. And most importantly, there a teacher has to be there, teacher has to come and teach, deliver, you know. These are orthodoxies. Moment we say that an educational institution, we presume that these things have to be there. But now, if I ask that, do I need to have a classroom to offer education? Do I need to have students sitting in front of me? Do I need to have students sitting in front of me at the same time? When I'm speaking, they are listening and asking me questions. So, do I need to have a tournament exam the way we conduct? Do I need to ask the same questions to every student of a class? All these things are never asked because we take it for granted that if we are talking about a particular business, particular activity, the certain things have to be there the way we are used to it. Even we set up an office, we immediately say, okay, there has to be a front desk person who should sit there the moment the visitors come, okay, would give a registry book, okay, where it will, they will have to write that my time, name, address, home, the purpose of the visit, all these things. I mean, all these things and many other things we do in our day-to-day businesses as a requirement which we never question. And this is what we call orthodoxy. And sometimes, if you challenge those orthodoxies, that if you ask that, okay, if I have to provide education, do I need to do all these things? Can I provide education in any other way? You know, that means that, you know, we are challenging the solution to the problem which we are offering, because customer is coming to me to seek solution to a problem. Problem is that, okay, that the customer requires some education. The problem, getting that education is a problem, so they come to me and I offer the solution. And But often what happens that we don't actually bother to find out that maybe the solution is not suitable for the customer. Sometimes we even without inquiring the customer's problem, we start offering solutions. We offer courses first without even asking the customer what actually they would like to study while coming there. So same way, we say, okay, if I'm thirsty, that's a problem, I need some water to drink. So the bottle manufacturers will come with a bottle of water to address that problem. But maybe there's some other solution so that I can keep my body hydrated. I need to drink the water. So that's the one thing that I think in the to innovate in this world which is driven by innovation, we need to challenge these orthodoxies. Every whatever business we are in, then related to that, that we have to also, we have to develop that inquisitive questioning mind. I mean, often we take it for granted that questioning someone, some authority is a bad thing. But I think we have to take it in the right spirit. That, because in this kind of a situation, this kind of changing world, nobody probably can say that, okay, he or she has the right solution. And even the leader also may not have the right solution. So it's important, or extremely critical actually, for an organization to allow that opportunity for anyone to question anyone. And this is not to insult anyone. It is just to find a better solution which is acceptable to a customer. So possibility to question the leader in any organization is also very important. Sometimes doing the opposite. Often we say that, okay, that if I want to graduate, I have to study, I have to come, I have to read. If we do the opposite, say, okay, I say that if you want to really study, if you want to get, if you want to become a graduate, I mean, if you want to be qualified, maybe I don't need to study. Just do the opposite. Maybe I need to, maybe by playing games, I can be probably much more qualified person. So because the moment we think from the opposite direction, it forces us to think. So that's, I think also it is important that, okay, we have to be realistic, because probably to run a business, we do so many different things from morning to evening. We have to prioritize that which kind of orthodoxies we first question. Not every small thing, I'm not asking that every small activity which you do, we have to now challenging. Because then what happens that you're all 24 hours, you will be spending on, probably spending on issues which are not that a priority issue. And you'll be spending time, because time is limited, 24 hours a day you have. So prioritize the major thing and identify those orthodoxies which are probably occupying major portion of the organization's attention and time. Identify those orthodoxies and start questioning.